A reading from the letter of the Hebrews. When Christ came as high priest of the good things that has to come, passing through the greater and more perfect tabernacle not made by hands, that is, not belonging to this creation, he entered once for all into the sanctuary, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkle of the heifer ashes can sanctify those who are defiled, so their flesh is cleansed, how much more with the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offer himself unblemished to God, cleanse our conscience from dead works to worship the living God. For this reason he is the mediator of the new covenant, since a death has taken place for deliverance from the transgressions under the first covenant, those who are called may receive the promise of eternal inheritance. The author of this letter is trying to remind us of a very important issue, that in the covenant that Moses sealed with his people there on Mount Sinai was ratified by the sprinkler of the calf and the bulls that he has slaughtered, and also of the spot who will do what the Lord has commanded us to do, he sprinkled the other blood on the people, ratified and cleansed the sins of the people. How much more the blood of Christ, the divine blood, will take away and cleanse us from our sins and make us unblemished to be offered to God the Father, atone for his worship. That's why the author is trying to remind us of a very important issue, that Christ, by his very passion and death, by his suffering and dying and rising from the dead, he becomes the mediator. He who was God from eternity, in time he became flesh. He now is the mediator between God and us. And so through him, by his suffering and what he accomplished for us, we have now the call to be children of God. And because we are children, by that adoption that he gave us, the virtue of immersion and baptism, we are now heirs of the kingdom. How beautiful it is to understand that this author is trying to remind us that this everlasting covenant that God has made with us by the very shedding of his blood, take away all the other covenants, those covenants that by which they end to be broken, and even they defile them, especially Adam and Eve, when they defile the order of God not to eat from the tree, because they want themselves to be equal to God according to the instigation of the evil one. And that's why today, as we continue to commemorate on the great mystery of the order, that God, through his Son, left us his presence, his body and blood, soul and divinity. He is telling us that through this Eucharist, we are cleansed. And every time we come and approach the sacrament, we need to cleanse ourselves, to be unblemished, to enter in union with the one who is holy, so that we who are filled with his grace in this life, with neatness, give us the courage to move on to our destination. That destination which is the promise of the Eucharist. That's what we say in the prayer of the beautiful benediction. That Jesus is the ram, is the promise of eternal life. That he died and rose so that we will live and will live for our eternity with him. May these words you just read, and may the meditation you just made, help us to see the dignity of whom we are born, how much God has loved us, and what God wants from us, that we cleanse ourselves from death and defilement, so that our blemish as we become, we can worship the true God, we can give glory to God.